What I would like to tackle in this video is what I consider to be a particularly interesting limits problem. So let's say we wanted to figure out the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of sine of x, and this is where it's about to get interesting, sine of x to the 1 over the natural log of x power. And I encourage you to pause this video and see if you can have a go at it, fully knowing that this is a little bit of a tricky exercise. So I'm assuming you have attempted. Some of you might have been able to figure it out on a first pass. I will tell you that the first time that I encountered something like this, I did not figure it out on a first pass. So definitely do not feel bad if you fall into that second category. Because what many of y'all probably did is you said, okay, well, let me think about it. Let me just think about the components here. If I were to think about the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of sine of x, well, that's pretty straightforward. That's going to be 0. So you could think of like this part of it is going to approach 0. But then if you say, and you could say, I guess I should say, the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of 1 over natural log of x, and this is why we have to think about it from the positive direction. It doesn't make sense to approach it from the negative direction. You can't take the natural log of a negative number. That's not in the domain for the natural log. But as you get closer and closer to 0 from the negative direction, the natural log of those values, you have to raise e to more larger and larger negative values. This part over here is going to approach negative infinity, is going to go to negative infinity. 1 over negative infinity, 1 divided by super large or large magnitude negative numbers, well, that's just going to approach 0. So you could say that this right over here is also going to be equal to 0. But that doesn't seem to help us much, because if this thing is going to 0 and that thing is going to 0, it's kind of an implication that, well, maybe this whole thing is going to 0 to the 0 power. But we don't really know what 0, let me do those colors, 0 to the 0 power. But this is one of those great fun things to think about in mathematics. There's justifications why this could be 0, justifications why this could be 1. We don't really know what to make of this. This isn't really a satisfying answer. So something at this point might be going into your brain. We have this thing that we've been exposed to called L'Hopital's rule. If you have not been exposed to it, I encourage you to watch the video, the introductory video on L'Hopital's rule. And L'Hopital's rule, let me just write it down. L'Hopital's rule helps us out with situations where when we try to superficially evaluate the limit, we get indeterminate forms, things like 0 over 0, we get infinity over infinity, we get negative infinity over negative infinity, and we go into much more detail into that video. And it seems like, well, this is kind of, it feels like, you know, we're getting a 0 to a 0. It's kind of, we're getting this strange beast, and it at least evokes the notion of L'Hopital's rule. And so you will not be, as we'll see in a few seconds, you're not wrong for that L'Hopital's rule neuron to be triggering in your brain, although you can't apply it directly to this right over here. L'Hopital's rule does not apply to, or directly apply to, the 0 to the 0th form. But what we can do is construct a problem where L'Hopital's rule will apply, and then use that to solve, to figure out what this is going to be. And this was essentially the tricky part of this exercise. Well, what do I mean? Well, if we set y equal to y of, and maybe let me write it this way. If we set, and I'll write y, I could just write y, but I'll say y is clearly a function of x. If we say y of x is going to be sine of x to the 1 over natural log of x, this thing right over here is essentially saying, what's the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of y? And once again, we don't know. Maybe it's 0 to the 0, but we don't know what 0 to the 0 actually is. But what we could do, and this is a trick that you see a lot, and anytime you get kind of weird things with exponents and, you know, whether you're doing limits or derivatives, and as you'll see, it's oftentimes useful to take the natural log of both sides. Well, what happens if you take the natural log of both sides here? So on the left-hand side, you're going to have the natural log, and whenever I think of natural log and e, either way, I always think of the color green for some bizarre reason. But we'll say the natural log of y is equal to, if you take the natural log of this thing, actually, I don't want to skip steps here because this is an interesting. So it's going to be the natural log of all of this business of sine of x, let me write it this way, sine, I want to do this in that orange color, the natural log of sine of x to the 1 over the natural log of x. Well, we know from our exponent prior, our logarithm properties, that the logarithm of something to a power, that's the same thing as the power, 1 over natural log of x, times the logarithm, in this case the natural logarithm, of whatever we're taking the of sine of x here. Sine of x. Or we could say the natural log of y, which I want to keep stay color consistent for at least one more step. The natural log of y is equal to, if we just rewrite this, this is going to be the natural log of sine of x, the natural log of sine of x over the natural log of x. Well, this is all interesting, but why do we care about this? Why did I do this? Well, instead of thinking about what is the limit, as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of y, let's think about what the natural log of y is approaching as x approaches 0 from the positive direction. So let's figure out what the limit of this expression right over here is as x approaches 0 from the positive direction. What is the natural log of y? What is this whole thing? Not y, what is the natural log of y approaching? So let's think about that scenario. So let me do this in a new color. So we want to figure out what is the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of this business. And I'll just write it in one color, the natural log of sine of x over the natural log of x. And I don't know why I wrote one time in print and one time in cursive. I'll just be consistent right over there. Now, why is this interesting? Well, see, in the numerator here, this thing's going to approach 0. Natural log of 0, you're going to approach negative infinity. This thing right over here, natural log of, as you approach from the positive direction, once again, you're going to approach negative infinity. This gives you that indeterminate form. So this is giving you that indeterminate form of negative infinity over negative infinity, which is neat because this triggers, or at least tells us, that L'Hopital's rule may be appropriate here. So we could say that this is going to be equal to the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction. Let me give myself a little bit more real estate to work with. And I can take the derivative of the numerator and the derivative of the denominator. Derivative of the numerator. So the derivative of the numerator, apply the chain rule here. Derivative of sine of x is cosine of x. And then the derivative of the natural log of sine of x with respect to sine of x is going to be 1 over sine of x. So it's just going to be over sine of x. So that's the derivative of the numerator. And then the derivative of the denominator is just going to be 1 over x. 1 over x. So this is all going to be equal to, this is equal to the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of, I could write this as cosine of x. And let's see, if I'm dividing by x, I am going to get, so this is going to be x over sine of x. And when I apply, and when I try to take the limit here, I'm going to get a 0. Once again, I'm going to get a 0 over 0. So this doesn't feel too satisfying. But once again, this is where our limit properties might be useful. And this, as you can tell, this is not the most trivial of problems. But this is going to be the same thing. And this would take a little bit of pattern recognition. This is the same thing as, because we know that the limit of the product of two functions is equal to the product of their limits, this is the same thing as the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of, if we take this part, let me do this in a different color. If we take this part, that's not a different color. If we take this part right over here, so that's going to be x over sine of x, and then times the limit, so we put parentheses here, times the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of cosine of x. Now this thing right over here is pretty straightforward. You can just evaluate it at 0, you get 1. So this thing right over here is equal to 1. But what's this thing? And this might ring a bell. You might have seen the limit as x approaches 0 of sine of x over x. This is just the reciprocal of that. This is x over sine of x. But when you just superficially try to evaluate it, you get 0 over 0. So you can then apply L'Hopital's rule to this thing. So once again, this is quite an interesting scenario we find ourselves in. So this is going to be the same thing as the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction. Derivative of the top is 1. Derivative of the bottom is cosine of x. Well, this is just going to be 1 over cosine of 0 is 1. So this is just going to be equal to 1. So we have to apply L'Hopital's rule again to realize that this limit is going to be equal to 1. So 1 times 1 is 1. So this thing right over here is equal to 1. So this thing right over here, this thing right over here is going to approach 1, which tells you that this thing is approaching 1. So what do we now know? We now know, and I'll write it out in language. We now know that the limit of the natural log of y, the limit of the natural log of y as x approaches 0 from the positive direction is equal to 1. So if the natural log of y is approaching 1, what is y approaching? Well, in order for the natural log, so once again, we just know this thing right over here. We know this thing is 1, and this thing is the natural log of y. We now know that this thing, the limit as x approaches 0 of this thing is 1, and that's the same thing as the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive direction of the natural log of y. These things are equivalent, is equal to 1. Well, if the natural log of y is approaching 1, so if the natural log of y is approaching, let me write it this way, if the natural log of y is approaching 1, well, what must y be approaching? Well, to get the natural log of something that gets you 1, well, y must be approaching e, because natural log of e is 1. So then, y must be approaching e. And we are done, because that's what we cared about. We cared about what is y. This is y. Remember, we defined this whole thing as y. We said, what is y approaching as x approaches 0 from the positive direction? Well, we figured out that the natural log of y is approaching 1 as x approaches 0 from the positive direction. So that means that y must be approaching e. So this tells us that this thing right over here is equal to e, which is somewhat mind-blowing. We've seen other, you know, the e's popping up, and it's involving sine of x, and, well, of course, natural log of x, you expect e to be involved somehow. But it is a pretty fascinating problem in my mind.